You're looking at a cloudless sky in Vipava, Slovenia. End of June, high pressure area, not a single cloud in the sky. We're actually on the edge of a major heat wave affecting most of the Europe. Yet the temperature here was bearable. Maximum this week we had like 37 in Ljubljana, and yesterday here maybe 34, today even less, around 32 right now. It's just past 1 p.m. so the sun has passed its highest point in the sky. Should be also the hottest part of the day and also the best thermals. So these fly-offs now, I'm sure, will be very exciting. So the past 1.5 days we've seen lots of really low starts. Really, I mean, like if you were 50 meters high, that was already too high. Also the scores are telling. We did 7 rounds, so maximum was 6,000 points. And in order to reach 10th place and get a place in the final flights, you needed like 5,930 points. So you could lose only 70 points in 7 flights. That's the kind of skill people developed. It really shows that World Championship is fast approaching, and the skill that these pilots show is really amazing. There's barely any wind now. Yesterday it was changing constantly, fluctuating between east, west, south. So the only wind we didn't really have was north. Otherwise it was changing on a minute per minute basis. Also caused us some issues with which directions to start, which directions to land from. Some arguing as well, because one group started, half people started to the east, half people started to the west, which is not supposed to happen. But anyway, I think that was resolved satisfactorily. Now we are looking at 50 seconds till start of the first flight. I think landing points are now properly downwind from the corridor. There's still one judge running to his position. And 10 seconds to start. I expect lots of low starts, 20 to 30 meters. Some people went to the west. There are still 3 east of me. At least one is trying the trees down there. But everybody is really, really low. Okay, so let's focus. And the wind has picked up slightly now. I can feel it. There's now 5 people over the camp going west and 4 people here in the middle of the field already climbing. There's one joining them from below. Let's see if he makes it. Looks like he's in good air. But still didn't manage to catch the rest of the planes, which are now all comfortably high. From this height it's no problem to make full time. So even the guy who started into the wind to the east is now over here, slowly getting carried with the wind, and will eventually join the rest of the flock. All 10 planes are now west from us, downwind, mostly the same patch of the sky. I hope they are distributed wide enough so that there are no mid-air collisions. Although on the moment it looks quite dense in there. It's hard to say how far apart the planes are, but let's hope that the farther they are, the more apart they are. So for sure it's easiest for the guys at the top. Let's see if I can zoom in on them. Not really. I guess the only thing that remains is wait for the remaining 9 minutes for them to come back down. Nothing else to do really. This is Czech competitor Ludek Novotny, being helped by, assisted by Primož Rižner. Both are flying explorers. Primož is top competitor in Slovenia and he missed the flyoffs by something like 1.4 points. large number of Italian competitors actually qualified for the fly-offs here, together with a few of Austrian competitors and one competitor from Croatia, Damir Kosir, who is also one of the best pilots in Croatia right now. Yesterday afternoon he did an amazing recovery down the field from maybe 3 or 4 meters and managed to climb back to safety. That was an impressive sight. So some people are asking about what the top pilots are flying in the comments, and it's a typical mix of what you see on the market. I would say that majority of the planes in the air are all kinds of or all generations of Explorers. Then you have your mix of Pikes from Samba models and an Ultima here and there, and the models you see more rarely are the ones that are newcomers to the market, which are almost too many for me to cover. So still looks like market is dominated by Explorers. I would say that's because of their manufacturing capacity, which gives them the ability to really go down on the price. I see at least one of the pilots now decided to come back already, early. There's 3 minutes 40 seconds to go. Majority is still far downwind. There's now one plane that came back. Doing some relaxing solo flying and getting ready to land. Still more than enough height to climb back to safety if needed, but with 3 minutes to go, there's no need for that, so it's fine. Minutes to go. lots of whistling noises as expected. Seconds. Twenty. Ten. Very nice. Okay, two more flights like that, please. Second start, 15 seconds, I moved slightly downwind, I expect most of the actions will be here. Let's see if I was right. Low and slow. Let's follow the group here. This is now between 15 and 20 meters maybe. And some planes are really close. A good air or something. This is now difference between few meters. You are a few meters too low, you don't make it. You're a few meters higher, you climb out. Where's the border between the two? Hard to say. That's the magic of this sport. Anyway, flying at these low heights requires utmost precision. Any mistake that costs you maybe half a meter or 1 meter could be your ticket to the ground. But these are the top 10 pilots at this competition, and looks like they will all make it. So there are 7 planes in this group, and then there are 3 guys still behind. Working the same thermal, I guess. Also climbing out slowly. No, the green plane now lost some height. He should move out to the field more. That's interesting. Looks like now the air is better out in the field. Yesterday it was over the trees and behind the trees. And they're all climbing out just fine. So it will be interesting to check the results at the end, what kind of start heights people had. But we were already discussing one thing. So you can do a simple experiment. You can fix your fuselage to a table, power it up, start your motor, turn it off, and check what altitude your altimeter displays. And most of us observe something like 5, 7, 10, 12, 15 meters even. And that was from the fuselage not even moving an inch in any direction. So what happens is that our height is pressure based. That's how the altimeter measures it. And the fast moving air created by the propeller has a slightly lower pressure. And the logger registered that as a higher altitude. And with the starts like this, in weather conditions like this, this can become important. So what to do? I was already thinking about placing the logger somewhere outside of the airstream of the propeller, maybe tail or wingtip or something like that. But I would need to lay down some extra wiring to perform this experiment. But at some point I'll definitely do it. So if you're a top pilot and basically climb out from 3, 4, 5 meters, basically a hand toss, and then the altimeter shows you like 20 meters, that's, I guess, bad for your ego and bad for your result if this happens on a competition. So another thing I'm curious about is the Plus design with the pusher propeller. Does it also suffer from this, or is it immune? Definitely something to check. So now I'm talking more and paying less attention of where I'm pointing my camera. But still the planes are again climbing out continuously, also gaining in the distance. And it's now like 8.5 minutes till the end of the flight. And no one looks like they have any issues or problems achieving that time. Another nice thing I noticed is that the organizer here actually remembered to change the points the pilots start from in each of the fly-off rounds. And this is something it is mostly neglected at most of the competitions, I would say. And I don't think it's right. Even in the fly-offs, pilots should be either randomly placed to the points, or as they do here, moved 3 points up for each start. There's now 2 minutes and 15 seconds remaining, and pilots are getting ready to land. Just a few of them are low, most that I see are still relatively high. Although there's no real need for that. But I feel wind picking up slightly, so maybe pilots opted for a higher approach angle and a higher approach speed just to be on the safe side. To go. Seconds. Very nice, very nice. All landed practically in the last 2 or 3 seconds. Okay, one more flight and we're done. 1 minute till the third start. And I moved again. I hope to get some really low level action. Camp here is now mostly empty, since most of the people already left. But still, it looks like we'll finish early than at other competitions. It's now around 2 p.m. and this is the last flight already. So we'll be done and packed by 3 p.m., which is very nice. Allows you to do a long distance travel. Thank you. Okay, now really close to the ground. Only two planes behind me, over the trees, and the majority is here, in the middle of the field, as I expected, since this was the best air in the previous two flights. Now with the mountain as a background, let's see what they can do. So these are some extremely low heights. Especially those two guys that are a bit more further out. There is a constant slight breeze from the east, and looks like they will all make it. So the lowest now is the plane with the green wingtips. I think he won't make it, but the others look good. Yeah, now he's landed. So the next lowest is about here. And this is now like 20 meters plus and climbing. And this is what I was talking about before. 1 meter too low, you don't make it. 1 meter higher, you climb out. Not sure if this is just a bit of luck or a lot of skill. Maybe a combination of both. Now the wind has picked up more, at least the most wind that we had in the past few hours, which I guess is good news for all the planes that are now already safely high in the sky. Okay, so that guy that looked like he's in good air decided to come back closer, which I don't think was the best of ideas. He should have moved either to the left or to the right instead, not returning directly into the wind. No, another zero, unfortunately. So flight number 3 will give us only 8 out of 10. The remaining 8 will have no problem making the full time. And again, I now see a bird joining them. Let's see if I can zoom in on that. Really far in the distance. I would totally need a bigger lens to follow them. Let me just move back to the landing points instead. So it's now 5 minutes to go and things are getting interesting. Looks like majority of the pilots decided to come back and lost lots of height in the process and are now working those trees here to get the last 5 minutes of flying out of them. There are three planes here and two more in the middle of the valley. Still, again, it looks like in the middle of the field the air is better. Four minutes to go. And I need to fix the camera mount. Two minutes. Remaining planes are comfortably high. And there in the distance we have some paragliding. Over that mountain. Losing height fast. seconds. Very nice, very nice. No collisions, no drama. That's what I like. Now let's see the final results. So first two flights are already published. And look at those numbers. So this one is especially fascinating. 8 meters start height. Very nice. I think third flight was even lower. Let's wait for that one. These are now the final results. Third flight here. And overall score. Total Italian domination, right? Very nice.